Episode 306, Florida versus Oiland. It's ladies' month, but Pigeon isn't here. Women's History Month, diary and questions, and beer.
Beer. Which plant seed should this bullet poop?
Ferns.
Ferns.
Hemp.
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 The manhood flying out of my mouth.
Reach in at your own risk. This is the Loaded Couch.
All right, and we're back with episode 306 of Loaded Couch, and I'm the man who thinks Pigeon is boycotting being on the show as a cry for attention. Scotch Hound.
This does reek of blue. Somebody talk to me.
Listen, you guys don't even reach out anymore.
Spaceland's cool.
All right, listeners, yes, Pigeon Pegleg is still not here, so if you guys are missing his nasally, whiny attitude, who likes to talk about, you know, interesting racially driven things, feel free to reach out to him at Pigeon Peg Leg on Twitter.
Our resident racist is missing.
And we're not talking about Celtic Fox.
No, he's off now. He's perma-banned.
That's right, yeah. He's our resident German, what the heck walk did they do? Didn't they have that march called
that's
something?
Deflake.
Yeah, exactly.
There was a walk to it.
Soldier walk. Yeah, exactly.
Like when they got a poo in a chamber and you try to squeeze it in and get to the toilet. That walk. That's the one.
Oh, my God. Dude, everybody knows that, especially if you were ever a kid and you were out playing for just a little bit too long. Come running back to the house, make it right to the back porch, and you're like, damn it!
One more round of hide and seek. Oh, find me.
Wait a minute. Why are you crouched behind that bush? I can't stand. I can't bend over. I can't not stand. I can't bend over. Don't make me move. Leave me alone.
Hey, everybody, smoking back here. Take it.
I ain't the smartest of men. Before I'm sitting, it looks like you taking that shit. All right. Pre-game dog of the mouth. Or what's happening in Florida?
Oh, God.
All right. I found a Florida man gets a misdemeanor summons from a police officer to appear in court to explain to a judge because the police officer made the argument that if he was driving down the road, he'd have to explain to his 7-year-old what the meaning of this guy's sticker on his back window meant by saying, I eat ass.
So he had to swear testimony. I swear to tell the truth. And the judge questioned him on this.
Well, the way he explained it, I guess it is, they said it's technically the way it's written up, it's a misdemeanor for having anything derogatory, you know, any
like lewd
yeah,
comments
on your, right. On your vehicle, on your moving vehicle.
Okay.
So he got pulled over for that, and the guy was like looking at the cop like, you serious? And he's like, I have 4 kids. He's like ranging from, you know, 13 years old to 4 months old. And he's like, if I'm riding in the car, and my 7-year-old goes to me, Dad, why does that guy's truck say I eat ass? What am I going to explain? So I'm going to give you this summons so you can go to a judge and you can explain why you have I eat ass in the back of your truck. Just like,
oh, I support this ticket. I'm in favor of this. You could say it, but you need to broadcast it.
Seriously. So then the cop says, he's like, okay, well, I can't just let you leave with that still on there. So I need to. And the guy's like, you're not encroaching on my First Amendment rights. He's like, you have to get rid of that lewd thing. So I'm going to need you to remove a letter from this statement, to make it not be lewd anymore. So he removed the I.
So now it's more of a command.
That's right. Just eat ass.
More than a statement. Eat it. All right.
I guess you're not explaining that. It's just, okay.
Yeah, there's no explanation, yeah. Your Honor.
I guess the cop can tell his kids it's an encouragement for zombies, I guess.
Right. Well, maybe that cop doesn't want to talk to his kids. He's like, I'm not doing that. Like, I'd rather give you a ticket,
that's right,
and I'll see you in court than me talk to my own kids.
That's right. I'm going to have the judge make you explain why you eat ass. But, okay.
Right, you explain it.
That's right, yeah. All right, moving on. Naples, Florida. A man was arrested for presenting, quote, dank gummies and, quote, medicated nerds rope to deputies while looking for his ID. So the authorities had been called on Demisio due to his reckless driving around the gas pumps at a Circle K. And when the police arrived, Demisio asked for help calling AAA due to his car not starting. The police then noted that there were no keys in the ignition. And when asked for his ID, Demisio found his keys in his pocket, along with some drugs, before he was able to find his ID.
Bro, you're telling me they're there the whole time? I feel stupid. Write me a ticket for dum-dum.
That he brought them out of his pocket to just sit them on the seat in front of the police officers while he's looking for his ID. Don't get me wrong. He's not the most intelligent man. But
Clearly. He couldn't find the keys in his pocket at the gas station because he said he was driving around the gas pump. So he got there.
He did.
So they weren't at home or
no.
lost somewhere.
But he couldn't get his car started because he took the keys out and put them in his pocket. And immediately forgot.
There's my keys.
Nope, that's not them. That's the dank gummies. Nope. That's the medicated.
You want some?
Worms. Nerds worms. Nerds rope.
Nerds rope. Oh, these are dope. I just got them. From my bro. Am I under arrest now?
Yeah. Wait. Here's my ID. What are you arresting me for? I gave you my ID.
Bro, what the hell?
No,
oh, Florida.
That's fantastic. All right, last one. Deerfield Beach, Florida. Two men lied about being U.S. Marshals. One of them, I think, was like 51. The other one was like 83 or something like that. Lied about being U.S. Marshals to avoid having to wear a mask at a South Florida resort. And when they became suspicious, the real cops were called, and they were arrested for falsely impersonating federal officers.
Nice. The extent people go to pretend like wearing a mask is infringing upon anything is pretty incredible. Like, just put it on. It's so much easier than to deal with any of this stuff.
Yeah. And they said that I think they were saying that they were trying to intimidate the employees of the hotel that were telling them to put a mask on by saying they were going to have them arrested. We're U.S. Marshals. We're going to have you arrested for telling me to put a mask on.
Okay, then you arrest me right now since you're a U.S. Marshal. Go ahead and do it. Do it. Yeah. Do it. Arrest me. Right. Go ahead.
Well, I can. I got to go watch somebody in witness protection, but I could do it.
I left my cuffs in the car. You're lucky. Go get the squad car.
That's right.
I'm 100 years old, though. I'm not arresting anybody.
80-something. God.
What time is dinner? It's 2 o'clock.
I'd walk back to the car, but my walker is like 20 feet away.
Ugh, I'm exhausted. I need a nap.
Holy hell. All right. Thank you, Florida, for some more fun.
Yeah, right, Florida.
Beer mash.
Endless stories.
That's
beer
right. Mash. It is kind of fun to look for those. I mean, a lot of them come up, and it's a lot of just political bullshit. Trying to find ridiculousness, but it is fun when you do find them. All right, what are you drinking?
I got Cloud Sourced from Two Roads Brewery. It's an IPA from Stratford, Connecticut. No space in between the letters. Hazy yellow in color and 6.5%. What about you?
Ooh, I got the Tessellation from Intervase Brewing. It's an IPA out of Phillipsburg, New Jersey. It's in a quart can.
Quark, wow.
Yeah, I got a 32 fluid ounce.
Tall boy.
That's right.
He's tall and thick.
That's right. Got some girth like kelk. It's a cloudy yellow in color and 8.2% alcohol.
Well, I never heard of Intervase. Are they new?
Yeah, it's a small microbrew downtown from where I live.
Down by you.
Yeah.
Awesome. Cool.
All right. Speaking of beer, we have some beer news. The beer crawls that everybody might have heard of may start turning into beer runs. And that doesn't mean like the runs in your pants. It's Harpoon Brewery, as well as some others, have started adding electrolytes to beer in an effort to expand to a new demographic.
It's got electrolytes.
That's right.
It's an idiot. Anytime I hear that for now until eternity, all I ever think of is Idiocracy. But it's got electrolytes.
It's got to be good.
What's plants crave?
It's got to be good. So this isn't. So I guess this is over and above the light beer craze that's been pushing for to try and draw in or wrangle in new drinkers. They're trying to get the exercise fanatics now too.
All right, look, you could be CrossFit and then slam down a harpoon.
That's right. I mean, they already have those. What are those? There's like softball games that you go and, or like the golf ones where there's like a keg at every third hole or whatever.
Right. You're loaded by the time you get to the 18th hole.
Right. Yeah. You can't even swing the damn golf club without smacking yourself in the face.
Right.
So, yeah. Hey, maybe if they add electrolytes, it won't be so bad.
Right.
All right. Let's take a break and we'll be back with Let's Talk Beer.
All right. Games.
You like games. Good cover, good cover.
I got you.
Need a friend? Pigeon too. Maybe you could be his friend. Ah, screw him. Reach me at scotchhound_LC or our website, photocouch.com.
I hate tea and I hate Kelk. But I love the Load of Couch podcast. So listen on your favorite apps and our website, theloadofcouch.com.
Let's
talk
games.
Games.
And beer. Since I got called out last week by our number one fan, He goes, hey, hey, I'm a regular listener, and I've noticed that you haven't been checking your beers in on Untappd. He's like, don't get me pissed.
You're right. like, you're right. Fair enough. I owe you.
I did. I was like, I've been real bad at doing that lately. It's
Send him 1,000 TLC bucks for his troubles.
I know. Yeah. But it's funny because he's like, I hear you drinking beers. You're talking about drinking beers. I just don't see them checked in. I'm like, ah.
I just don't see them.
I know, I know.
You can't prove it.
Yeah, exactly.
Picture didn't happen.
There's no picture proof.
Right.
You guys are liars. That's what Pigeon always thinks. Lying about drinking over here. Anyway, yeah, speaking
the guy
of...
who has water for every...
yeah, for every start of show. It's only because I have a 16% after it.
You had all day to drink water. We do this at night.
Right. All right, so beer refill. You still drinking the same?
Yeah, I'm nursing,
and apparently. I've got my. You've got your cloud sourced. I've got my tessellation since I got 32 ounces of freedom. All right, games.
Got
31
to go.
Nice. Dan, what'd you play?
Not a lot. I don't even know what it was I was doing. Nothing.
But I'm excited about the first one.
I played some Donut County.
Okay.
And I guess I'll come right back to that. And then I started some Outer Wilds, but that's our game of the month. I started it. So I'll come back. But Donut County is super weird.
Yes.
Super weird. Definitely one of the stranger games I've ever played. And I'm stuck at a point. So I played a bunch and I played with my daughters and let them be the hole. Mm-hmm. And they were getting a kick out of it because they just thought it was funny every time stuff would fall in there. So they definitely enjoyed it. They're like, I want to be the hole. And then actually, you know what they enjoyed more was just cranking on the A button to get through the dialogue. They're like, let's hurry up and get back to the hole.
That's
so
like
I have no idea what the story is.
That's like the best part of the game is the commentary.
They just blast through that. I just want to be the whole time. So I really don't even know what the story. I mean, I know a little. I got the general idea is that the raccoon somehow invented this hole, and he's sort of taking the pigeon peg leg approach. He's like, what? I was trying to help you.
Right. I've been playing a game. Him.
Right. I'm just doing you a favor. Sorry.
Right. Right. Yeah. Exactly.
So I made it up to how far into the game did you make it?
I beat it.
Or did you not play this yet? Oh, you beat it.
Yeah.
So I'm up to the part where I'm in the, I guess it's the laboratory? Let's call it a laboratory.
Oh, yeah, okay. Going after the Rat King. Or the Raccoon King.
Yeah. Yeah, so I think it has a feel like I'm getting close to the end, but I don't know how true that is.
Pretty close.
But it feels like because it's so different.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm up to the room, and I'm stuck on a puzzle where it's the rotating wheel, and there's a firework. There's a bird that drinks the water. There's the fireplace that has the flame to ignite the rocket.
Yep.
And then
the water puts the flame out.
Water puts the flame out. The bird drinks the water. There's the rocket, and there's the actual flame.
Yep.
I think that's four things. So I blew up the TV that the raccoon was on.
Yep.
But then I'm still stuck, and I don't know what else. I've shot the rocket everywhere, but clearly not the one place that I need to, because I'm still stuck in this friggin' mission.
You got to watch out where you're shooting your rocket there.
Yeah. Well, I was trying to aim it. Then there's also some like dangling electrical wires. I was like, that has to be where this goes. But I tried that, and that wasn't doing it. So I must be missing I'm sure I'm staring right at it and I'm missing something, but it's definitely entertaining and I feel like I'm very close to the end, so I'm going to go back because I would.
Yeah, you're getting close to a boss fight, which is good. Okay. That's a little bit challenging.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, this was by far the most challenging part of the whole game so far.
Right, but I completely recommend that you go back and this time you completely pay attention to the story. Because the banter, I think, is the best.
Right, okay. Yeah, I missed most of it because they were getting a kick out of, it's my turn to push the button. And right. Like, okay, I missed all that. What about you? Are you still hooked on Zelda?
Oh, I can't stop being hooked. I mean, granted, last week I didn't get a lot of time to play. Right. Just because I worked like a madman. Dude, it sucked. Mm-hmm. I worked a whole day on Friday, came home, went right back to work, and worked until 4:30 in the morning. I was like, jeez, crackhead.
When do you sleep?
Oh, God. Well, I slept until like 11:45 that Saturday afternoon or early late day, whatever. Right. But yeah, felt like a crackhead the rest of the weekend then.
Right. Right.
But I think I just got my, or I went and I got the elephant first. I beat him and Zora's Domain. So that's done. And I just went, I'm not going in order for some reason, although I did unlock Tarrytown.
Okay.
And I've got the first guy up there because I bought the house or whatever. And I got the guy with the last name Son up there, Grayson, I think, or Garrison or whatever.
Oh, yeah.
Then I went to the Gorons and I got the one Goron with the last name Son to come down and help him out with breaking the rocks on the island of Tarrytown. Mm-hmm. But then from there, I was supposed to try and do the Goron Divine Beast because if you kind of go along that way, I think that's second. And then going down to Gerudo is third. And then finally the Rito is the
desert,
fourth.
Right?
I ended up going to the Rito. That's the birds with the the flight thing with the wind that goes underneath you. I can't remember that.
Yeah, and that's the one where you have to travel around in the desert by like latching onto one of those sand
monsters.
No, that's
the Gerudo.
Oh, that's the Gerudo. I'm mixing up the two.
But the Rito, it's Revali's Gale. That one. One's super helpful. So I kind of went there second instead of going there first. Mm-hmm. So I just beat that last night. So
kind of cool. So I got two beasts down and two to go.
Yep. Yeah, exactly. And I got 13 hearts already. I'm trying. I'm getting as many Koroks as I can. I already have like 96 Koroks.
Okay. Wow. 10th of the way there.
Yeah. Like I said, 13 hearts and I've upgraded my stamina two or three times already. So I think I'm going to go into the Korok forest and try and get the Master Sword next and then venture down to get the last two Divine Beasts while I'm still looking for everything. But I might... This is a big might, but I might try and 100% the game. I'm not sure this time because it's going easy. Yeah, just because it's going easy and it'll be fun. But
yeah, have you fought any of those guys that
you
know which ones I'm talking about?
Yeah, the ones that shoot the arrows and
they're like half horses, centaur.
Yep, right. beast type thing. No, I avoid them as much as possible.
Me too. That's how I played. I'll just skip that.
Yeah, because dude, it was like I was even like the guy was fuzzy looking on the screen, like I could barely like make him out, and all of a sudden I'm just dead because he spotted me and shot me with an arrow even though I was hiding behind the wall and in my sneaking clothes. I'm like, what the hell?
How did he find me?
Right. Yeah, no idea. But
it's like those freaks that figured out how to parry every one of those laser beams and like wipe out a whole like
the guardians
and wipe out a whole shrine full of them in like one move, like cling 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 cling, like, block everything. Like, what are you doing?
Yeah, I actually had a shrine that I went to that was a major test of skill. So it's the most difficult of those mini guardians.
I hate those.
And I actually beat it with a parry.
Nice. Yeah. Okay. Cool.
Nicole was like, "Oh my god, how'd you do that?" Like, she was so excited.
Hey, Don.
That's it. That's me. Come on over here and say.
No Beat Saber this week?
Very little bit. Yeah, at my brother-in-law's house, we got to play a little bit. So I got sweating like a pig, of course, because for some reason I can't not do the 6-minute song, but whatever. Yeah, just a little bit. I did. Yeah, that's good. I forgot that I played that, but yes, I did play a little bit of that.
I just knew how much you were into it.
I know. I can't stop. It is like my one exercise kind of game.
Yeah, I got to do something.
I know. That's the only thing I'm doing. Well, I can't say that because I am working construction now, so I'm up on my feet a lot of the day. I'm standing a lot, but
yeah. At least you're moving your body. Yeah, I sit in a chair always.
Yes. Well, hey, I've been doing that since 2011, so I'm just getting started.
Yeah. All right. Well, Something.
All right, Microsoft News. Bethesda joins Xbox Game Pass, and there are already 20 games to pick from, including games like Fallout, Doom, Dishonored, Prey, Elder Scrolls series, Wolfenstein, and more.
What a good deal. Like, I was thinking that the other night when I put Outer Wilds on. It's almost good and bad all at the same time that they have this Game Pass now, because it used to be where you buy a game, and that would be the one you'd play for a while because you spent all the money on it.
Yep.
Now it's like, oh, I try something. If I hate it, I just go on to the next one. Like, I don't give anything a chance if it doesn't grab me right away. So it's great in order to skip all the bad games, but it's bad because there's so much content. You're like, I feel like I never give anything a real fair shake.
Right. Yeah, I'm not investing my time into one game like I should. Right.
Yeah. If I'm bored after 15, 20 minutes, just pick something else.
Yeah, exactly. But then you kind of get like game paralysis too, where you're like, what do I want to play? I don't know.
Right. Now I got to download it and wait. Who's got that kind of time?
Yeah, exactly.
Think ahead. Like, what do I want to play tomorrow?
Yeah.
first world problem.
It's kind of, I think that's pretty good for us that Bethesda's coming there, because it's just one of those other big ones that has a lot of games that we'd like to play, offering up games early and free. Well, not free,
right,
but free.
Yeah. That's a lot of content. Yeah. That's a good price for a lot of content.
Exactly. All right, Monster Energy Supercross releases their fourth game, which would be Monster Energy Supercross 4, and it looks good graphically. Me personally, I've never had any success in an MX game that didn't have some wonkiness to it.
Yeah, there was the way they steer is always a little strange, or the graphics get hung up when you're doing like some extreme move.
Yeah. From what what I saw of it, like I said, graphically, gameplay wise, it looked really good. But the write up said that the first issue that they have is just the learning curve is extreme.
Ugh.
Right.
Yeah, so, it's a bummer.
I know. It's because I always watch these and I think they're fantastic looking. I'm like, that could be a lot of fun, because I do like riding a motorcycle and this just looks like a lot of fun. Granted, it could probably be really repetitious and stuff, but you know, for something that's, you know, a few $30 or something like that, I'll give it a try and play it a little bit off and on. Right. But I don't know. It's kind of a hard sell. I guess I'm not into it as much as I used to be.
And look, maybe if there was a good multiplayer crowd and where the, you know, online races were different all the time, that would keep you coming back.
Right. Yeah.
Is it for the new generation?
I think they said it's playable on the X or the One. I'd have to double check that. I didn't look at that specifically.
Yeah, I was curious.
I would assume it's coming out for the Series S and X, but it's also playable on the One. But I could be wrong.
Okay.
All right. It Takes Two. It's a new co-op puzzler. It was announced for pre-order because it drops March 26th. It did look like a lot of fun. You're kind of these two characters that are kind of attached. The guy was saying that there's the way the gameplay goes, if you guys aren't working together well, there's like some interaction from the game to help you kind of better mend your character's playability or something like that, where you guys work together better as a team, or kind of introduces things to help you work better as a team and all. So it looked pretty good, especially for people like Pitch and Peg Leg who love playing co-op games. So
like a good co-op game.
Yeah. Like we are. Oh yeah. He and I beat A Way Out.
Oh, did you?
Yes, we did. I'm pretty sure.
I have to give that a second shot. I only tried that one night with Omega, and the first 45 minutes were pretty slow because there was a lot of credits, and it was just like walking into the prison.
Yep.
And we were sort of like, what's going on here? Like, are we going to do something eventually? But I think we meant to give it a second chance and just haven't gotten back to it yet.
Right. Yeah, Pigeon liked it because when we're first walking in, I think I was doing the walk of shame into the jail, and he was already there. He's like, hey, bitch, you're my new fish. He's going, because he's standing up at the fence watching me walk in and stuff like that.
Oh, yeah, I was the fence guy.
Yeah, he's fresh meat. Anyway, yeah, that was a good one for that. Like the banter and stuff that we had going on was just retarded, but
right,
it was good.
Right.
Yeah. But yeah, this one it did look pretty cool game wise for being a puzzler. I like puzzlers, so I mean it would be interesting to play, but not everybody likes puzzlers. And I know getting co-op ones, because I was playing that Snipper Clips on Switch. I don't know. Did you try that at all?
No, I didn't try that, but it was making me think of Portal 2, and I've tried to play the co-op version of Portal 2, and that was tricky.
Okay.
Portal 2 was tricky enough by yourself with right. another person because, yeah, I mean, you really have no choice but to communicate.
Yeah.
It's like, all right, I'll shoot this hole and then you fire off this thing. Like, it's tough. I mean, it probably feels really good when you get a couple of them. I remember trying a couple of times that we would get through, like, a level or two, but it was exponentially harder when the two of you had to do it together.
Right. Yeah. Now the Snipperclips one, it's kind of like, yeah, it's interesting because you're these two little like thumb shaped characters and you have to like rotate your character to do different things. You can kind of like, crouch and let the other person jump on you and then snip out your shape so that you can catch ball, like a ball that falls or something like that and then transport it across. It's actually really challenging, but it is a lot of fun when you finally, like you said, get the, yeah, exactly. all right, that's It Takes Two is coming. All right, so the last thing in Xbox news is Xbox Community Game Club discusses how you can join in and win sweet giveaways just for playing games. But it seems you got to be a little bit savvy and willing to play with others and sharing in your adventure. And when I say savvy, I mean on like, you know, connecting through the internet and then being able to play with the people on the games
got
and
it.
Stuff in the Xbox and
got
on
it,
your Xbox stuff.
Right,
so. But it's pretty interesting because they had some giveaways, which seemed pretty cool. Some like actual swag, and I don't think it was just all in-game stuff. I think it was a lot of swag and like those types of things.
Okay.
Like they had a controller that they were offering and a headset and stuff that too. So
yeah, it's stuff you'd actually want.
Right. Yep. Exactly.
Yeah. Not just Minecraft T-shirt.
Right. Yeah. Yeah. Seriously.
Great.
Yeah.
Thanks.
Yeah. I went and joined this community club, and all I got was a stupid T-shirt. All right, Sony news. Severed Steel. It's a. Ooh, there we go.
It'll take forever. Forget it.
It's a single player shooter with a fully destructible environment. It has some bullet time. You're familiar with that, right? Where it goes slow mo when you're doing your. Yep.
Yeah, the Matrix mode.
Yep, exactly. And a one armed protagonist.
Oh, what happened to the other one?
Well, supposedly there was some kind of your part, or well, I guess you were taken into this research lab ever something or other company, and something went wrong during, I don't know, the research on you, and I don't know if they removed your arm or if your arm had been removed before you got there as to why they were researching on you, but they kind of just abandoned you and left you alone, and then you kind of just got pissed and they were working on other people, so now you're trying to make your way through this company and shooting everybody on your way out while rescuing these other people and stuff. So the gameplay itself looked like Tron graphics or graphically with like the very neon-y kind of lights and stuff. And it was a version of what the hell was that movie where it was the first person shooter. Jim liked it a whole lot.
Movie that was first person shooter, the one that kind of looked like real life Call of Duty and made everybody puke.
Yep, yeah, exactly. Is that
I
one?
Forget what the name of that one. Right.
Yeah, it was that one with like a mix of Mirror's Edge because it seems like there's just a lot of like sliding and running, jumping, kind of like ducking and diving type of things that are going on, and then that kind of mixed with again the Call of Duty Modern Warfare kind of single player, like you know that slide shooting and stuff that's going on. So
yeah, all right, cool. Yeah.
And that's coming later this year. If you get a chance, click on that link, Dan. It is pretty cool looking, but, you know, I don't know. I guess I would be okay with it. It's just a lot of the bullet time, a lot of like the, you're shooting one person and as you're doing like the slide shooting in that person, you have to immediately turn to like your right or your left, or you have to then jump from your slide and then shoot the guy that's behind that guy and
super shooter
kind of sort of. Yeah. Yeah. It looked a little bit intimidating, but, or maybe like if somebody has motion sickness, like you could easily kind of get motion sick from that. Like I was wondering when it was first showing, I'm like, holy shit, if this was in VR, I think I'd end up puking immediately. But
as you're describing it, like I'm just gonna pass in this game,
right? Yeah.
My stomach's already
it looked like it was a lot of fun because it looked like it could be like a shooter puzzler because of the way you have to make your way through the boards, kind of like you're dang super hot, but it's I don't know. It, gameplay wise it looked cool, but I'm not sure if it'd be for me.
Okay.
All right. Mundown. Yeah.
Mundown.
It's a folklore-inspired horror game, and the first full-length title from Hidden Fields. It's a one-man game development studio. Development started back in 2014, and the reason it's taken so long is every character scene and even environmental texture in the game is hand-penciled.
Jeez, 7 years.
The guy's been drawing, yeah, and creating the game and stuff for 7 years. So, I mean, he said he's like, I've been drawing forever. It's ridiculous how much I've been drawing.
My cramp by my hand.
But it looks really cool.
I can imagine.
Because it is like just in the, you know, pencil paper type of like appearance of everything, just like that gray and white kind of look. But
right.
Like graphically, the guy is a very talented artist for his pencil. It's not like just like stick figures and shit. It's like really detailed characters and all. So, but
yeah, he must have gotten a kick out of, you know, that must have been scratching multiple itches for this guy to stick with hand drawing a video game by yourself for 7 years and not get bored of it.
Yeah, and not get paid for 7 years.
Right. Right. Yeah. So it means he was probably doing his whatever his regular job was and coming home and let me get my next box of pencils ready.
Right. Seriously. Yeah.
Crack my knuckles. See you in the morning.
Yeah.
For 7 years.
Really? I know. That's a crazy thing because I'm like, you know, they should get like a shit ton of just like media coverage because of how long it's taken and stuff like that. But, you know.
Yeah.
We'll see.
What took longer, this guy by himself hand drawing or Cyberpunk?
Yeah, probably Cyberpunk. With like 1,000 people working on it.
Right. This dude did it with a pencil.
and my iPhone. Yep.
Yeah, my iPhone. Yeah. That's right. By hand. By himself. No big deal.
Taking pictures of each one. All right. So the game will be released on PS4, or if you're listening to this later, released on PS4 March 16th.
Cool.
All right, last thing in our PlayStation news. The PlayStation Now games from March is World War Z, Ace Combat 7, Skies Unknown, Infamous Second Son, and Superhot. And I think we talked about that last month. Pigeon had it written up or something like that. But just as a reminder for those who are part of the PlayStation Now games.
Yeah, I saw some footage for that Ace Combat. It looked pretty cool, too. But that was another one that was like, oh, well, I would last about 5 seconds in that game.
Do a barrel roll. Turn.
Well, nope.
See, I wanted to play Infamous Second Son a bunch when I saw it. It looked really, really cool. I know Pigeon played it and he didn't like hype it up at all for me. So I was like,
Right. So it sort of took the wind out of your sails there.
A little bit. But that's the thing. Right. If you overhype it, then I'm like, too. So I don't know.
Right.
There's like
it's the best game ever.
Right. I guess there is like a happy medium, but yeah, I don't know. Mm-hmm. And Superhot, I am interested, but I have it on the PSVR. I got it for Jonas, so I can just play it on the console. Whatever.
Cool.
All right, Nintendo news. Nintendo may have a beefier console with an OLED screen coming to market this year.
Yeah.
I guess there's been some kind of leaks or hints to the fact that this is going to be happening, but the OLED screen was kind of interesting.
Yeah, I think it's a good move. I mean, they're still selling Switches faster than everything else, right? I mean, so why not make another new one?
Right. But it's like, do you think they really need to, like, compete with PlayStation, Xbox?
I think it's the only similarities between the two is that they are video games, but Nintendo does its own thing, but they may want to be capitalizing on technology for whatever reason. Like, let's say that maybe by having the LED, I don't know if it does something for battery life or makes it lighter or makes it, you know, which could reduce either
the blacks shipping costs or
maybe makes their games look better, you know, just improvement. I mean, technology moves so fast that they're like, what we built for the Switch a couple years, you know, I don't know, what the hell, the Switch now, 3 or 4 years?
Yeah.
Okay, that's 4 years of technology. Same concept. We'll just change the screen, make it that much better, and then resell the original adopters, make them buy another one.
Right. But the crazy thing, I mean, it's like, I kind of agree that I don't think they need to play into the hype of, like, all this new stuff that all the games and stuff are going with the Xbox, like, Series X and the PlayStation 5, like, Pro or whatever, that they're, you know, these beefy, beefy, you know, like, systems that can play, like, the best games. But it's like, where is the happy medium that, they're making these games and they're finally opening it up to where, like, third-party, you know, developers and stuff are making games playable for Switch or for Nintendo? That it's like, okay, Nintendo, you finally hit, like, a point where you're not keeping up graphically and we can't really, you know, downplay these games to the point where they're going to play in your systems anymore, that we're going to get screwed as Nintendo owners.
Yeah, I wonder if that's could definitely be a good point, too, that the developers can't write it less than technology than they already have.
Right.
That could be, you know, hadn't thought about that, but.
But I know that they're also doing this to keep the price down as well, to make kind of games available to everybody, because it's their consoles mm-hmm. are always like $100 cheaper, it seems, or $150, $200, right. whatever, cheaper than whatever the big beefy console is of the season, so, or that year.
Yeah. Yeah, they're definitely their own thing. I mean, they're both video games, you know, PlayStation or Xbox versus Nintendo. Technically, they're both video games, but that's about it. I mean, other than that, they're two totally separate things.
Yeah. All right. Last thing in Nintendo is Animal Crossing is banned in China.
Huh?
Yeah. Well, when people have been taken to protesting China and then taking that into Animal Crossing, they shut that shit down real quick.
Like, nope, this is animals, and that's it.
That's right.
That's all.
So supposedly there was some, you know, I guess they've been, there was that British-owned colony, Hong Kong, not Hong Kong, it's,
Taiwan?
Nope. Yeah, it was a British-owned colony for a long time. It kind of, like, got left to its own, and now China's trying to take ownership of it, even though it's not really part of China.
Okinawa?
Nope. That's,
I'm just guessing now.
Yeah. I can't remember right now. I think it starts with an H and it's a longer word. Doesn't matter. Anyway, it's a big city. It's one of the biggest cities over in that area of the world. But I guess the people have been protesting that China does, or they want China out. They don't want to be under China rule because it's technically not part of China, although China's trying to just completely occupy it and be like, you're ours now. So people have taken to, you know, protesting since they're kind of being shut down from protesting, you know, in real life to doing it through Animal Crossing with some of the, you know, free design options that you have in that and then posting that online. Well, China, with their Chinese control of everything, has gone and removed that option by not allowing the game to run on their Chinese controlled internet service providers.
Jeez. Oh, yeah, you're going to protest? Watch this. You're not playing anything.
That's right. We won't let you do nothing.
See you later, Tom Nook.
Yeah. So I guess people are getting around it by getting foreign switches and stuff.
Hang Chow?
And show that the... I think they figured out how to log in as if it's coming from a different nation.
Right.
You know, through the console and stuff. But
change your... Yeah.
So, yeah, they're finding ways around it, but the Chinese government is locking everything that they can control down. So, thumbs up to communism.
Long cities in China where they begin with an H. Hangzhou?
Nope.
Hangzhou?
It's one of the largest ones over there. I watched that one. It was...
capital and most populous city of Zhejiang, People's Republic of China.
It's not in China, though. Hangzhou Bay. It's not... It's outside.
Like Hong Kong is its own thing.
Yeah.
I gotcha. All right. We can just keep guessing.
Beijing. I know. I'm looking now.
Changchun. Right. Xi'an.
Oh, God. I can't think of it. It's going to bother me now.
Huzhou.
I like that one. That's a good one.
I feel like I said that one. Definitely authentic. Pretty sure.
Jesus.
Wenzhou, Shanghai, Nantong.
Is it Shanghai?
Shaoxing.
I can't remember because it was.
My Chinese is getting better. My Mandarin is getting
that's
on point. Changsha, Chengdu. I think I'm ready to move.
Oh my God.
We're crushing it.
That's
Mandarin's
right.
So easy.
I think I'm ready to move, he says. Holy hell. Maybe it is Hong Kong. Is that the one that's...
Guangzhou? Well, Hong Kong is where they were having, like, all... You know, they're their own separate entity, but...
That's what it is, then. It is Hong Kong. I don't know why I thought it wasn't Hong Kong, then, but...
And it starts with an H, too.
Yeah.
You were right.
But I for some reason, I thought it was a much longer one-word thing. I didn't think it was that easy, but anyway...
It's Hong Kong.
Yeah, okay. Extra ong in there. I gotcha. Nice. But yeah, I watched that. It was that, what's that? Living, I think it was that TV show or whatever that was on Netflix. It was like living in urban areas, and it showed like how expensive it is to live in Hong Kong for how many people there are there and how these people are living in like a room that's the size of like a bed. And they're paying like, you know, $20,000 a year just to live there, as if it's like a regular rented like apartment, but all you have is a bed.
Right. There it is.
Yeah. You climb into it. It's like this little like rolling
2 feet
door.
2 feet by 5 feet.
Kind of, sort of. It's exactly right. They had the clothes all hung up above them because they were sleeping underneath their clothes. There's a TV tucked up in the corner. It's like 13 inches big. Oh, it was crazy.
That's like Michael Scott when he invited him over to look at his new flat screen. it's like an iPhone hung to the wall.
What was it? It was a what kind of screen was it? It is oh god. Calc had one too.
A teeny tiny little flat screen.
Well, no, it was plasma. That's what it was. Remember when she throws a thing in and knocks? That's a plasma screen TV.
It's so small.
Yeah, that's the one that Calc had a big screen of, but he used it as a heater instead of a television.
Oh my god, we had a plasma. It got so friggin' hot.
Right.
Like literally I'd be sweating. I'd be, why am I so hot down here? It's a TV.
My face is beet red and it's hot as shit in this house.
That's so hot.
All right. Last thing, multi-platform news. All right, so all the gaming industry, consoles especially, is celebrating Ladies in Gaming for Women's History Month with play this, right, play that, watch this, watch that, and hey, you could win some money too by doing all those things. Is that what women's history is supposed to be, or are they missing something?
I'm not sure. I think they're trying, I suppose.
Right.
Did they conference with any, whoever the women spokeswoman
probably
is?
Probably not. It's a YouTuber who's just like, hey, you guys can come and watch my channel.
Or just watch my channel. That's right. Hit subscribe. Smash that subscribe button.
Exactly. I'm just like, okay, I mean, I get it, because it's like they're all promoting, oh, this game all have female protagonists in them, and you should play them this month. It's like...
Yep, there's been female protagonists in games like for decades. That's right. Not new.
But it's like
Lara Croft been around since PlayStation.
Oh my god, she's been around since like the original PCs right. came out. Like the first right. like what the hell was that cow colored Gateway computers when they were first like right. huge. Lara yeah. Croft came out with her squared off boobies.
Yeah, Mrs. Pac-Man, how old is she?
Right. Exactly.
It's not new news.
Right. But it's just, I mean, I get it that they're just trying to promote women, but I don't know if they're missing something, because I don't know if that's promoting right. women. It's just trying to, hey, ladies, come and play more games type of thing. We're just trying right. to sell more shit.
Look, because there's girls in it, and you're a girl, so obviously you want this.
Oh, my God. Speaking of, the other night I went on to Twitch again. And it's been a long time and a lot of things have changed. Mm-hmm. And I really just wanted to go in and watch somebody playing a game. And one of the first things that I see is I'm scrolling through and it's just like this woman, girl,
titty girl
in skin tight, like, you know, halter top right. type of mm-hmm. exercise clothes and like the Jane Fonda workout gear with no like actual tight legging things on. And she's just right. on all fours doing stretches. Like with her like cleavage, just the main thing. And I mean, she, you can see her face and stuff like that, but I'm like, you really think you got 1200 viewers just because you're showing them the right way to stretch? I don't think so. She's like, thanks so much for coming to my channel. Listeners. I'm like, why is this playing as like a lead freaking video that's on front? I'm like, okay.
Right. Cause it's cheap, free softcore porn.
I guess.
That's why. Yeah. I mean, she was educating.
Thanks for the bits.
Be healthy.
Seriously, you can give them bits now when you know, like, because you earn bits as you watch and you conversate and you can, you know, and then you can give those bits away. So thanks for the bits.
Is that like new cryptocurrency?
I guess. I don't know. Speaking
Twitch,
of, I bought something.
Twitch bits. Mm. Did you buy Bitcoin or what'd you buy? Dogecoin?
Ethereum.
NFTs?
Ethereum.
Ethereum.
Yeah, it was down a little bit today, so I bought some.
Yeah. Best of luck.
Thanks.
Fingers crossed.
Oh, everything's up already.
It's worth something. Okay, sell.
Yeah, I'm actually in the green. I'm in the green. I probably just went and screwed myself, and I'll be back in the red again. But
yeah. Sell, you got to move fast.
And of course, it closed lower than I bought it for. Ah, poop. Whatever.
You got to be quick.
I know. Yeah, take my wins and get out.
3 seconds later, sell it. Boom! Just made $5,000.
That's right. Yeah. Oh my god.
Stunks.
Anyway, all right. Well, I'm happy Women's History Month. I hope you guys are getting more out of it than I am from the gaming console industry.
Yeah. Okay. All right. Go, girls.
Let's take one more break and we'll be back with Diary of the Mouth.
Dick Nip Tassels. Do you love foreplay? Does your man love to be teased? Does his erogenous zone make him scream off the charts? Does he love the nipple play? Well, does he have dick nips? If so, you're in luck. UW's Dick Nip Tassels are the best Dick Nip Tassels in the business. Just open the package, take the frayed end off the tassel, and create a distal hitch knot. Then take the middle part of the tassel and create a Steve Dorr stopper knot. Now grab his dick nip and, with the end of the tassel, make the munter hitch knot. Tie the munter hitch knot really tight. Now tug on distal hitch knot so that Steve Dorr's stopper no becomes taut with the included hooks attached to your belt loops. Don't skimp out. Use all 37. Then pull them close and show them who's the boss, who the Bassmaster really is. You can buy UW's Dick Nip Tassels on our website. www.tietheniptight.com.
Why are you sending me dirty pictures? Because you're going to make me get up and log into Pornhub and go
into the All right, I'm back with Diary of the Mouth. Dan, how's your cloud sourced?
Good. I finally drank some of it, so it's good. How about your tessellation? Excuse me.
It doesn't sound like it's as good as what you're enjoying. No, it's tasty. It's it's good. Got a grapefruity type of flavor to it. So.
Yeah, so it's a regular IPA. That sounds right.
Right. All right. Rate and Diary of Mouth. Okay. Oiland. We all know where Oiland is. It's Pigeon's favorite second home. Website that reviews garden sheds posted a job listing for a $70 an hour Minecraft gardening consultant.
That's a good role.
The said hire, or what's that?
That's a good role, 70 bucks an hour.
Yeah, seriously, that's not bad at all. So the said hire will lend a hand in video gaming and garden design skills to Minecraft players seeking help landscaping their virtual world.
Just to help? 70 bucks an hour?
Helping, but from what the explanation was, is they'll also help them because I guess they can spend in-game currency now to buy and design things.
Okay.
So they'll help them with minimizing the cost to get the looks and, I guess, build that they're looking for.
Jeez.
Mine coins, I think they called them. I didn't understand it. I'm like, is everything going coin-based? So much,
right. Everything's virtual currency right now. Okay. Solid gig for that Oiland guy.
Right.
Or girl, I suppose.
Whoever gets hired for that. I guess it could be anybody from anywhere because it's, as much as we're doing
it's
virtual.
Minecraft. Yeah, everything's virtual.
Yeah.
I might apply.
Right. 70 bucks an hour. Jesus.
Right. That's a good deal.
I imagine you'll have work for about 13 days.
Yeah. And done.
Exactly. And everybody's been done. That's right. Hall guide, gardens, and design. all right, and the last thing in our Diary of the Mouth, a driver was pulled over in Wisconsin by state patrol and was found to be using a camping chair as their driver's seat.
That's safe. That's very safe.
Can you imagine? Look, there's even snow on the floor. Was like the sunroof that's broken?
Everything's broken. There's no door.
Look how high it is. There's your no head seat. Has to be. Are you driving like Ace Ventura with your head out the sunroof? Look how high that thing is.
You'd have to be, or very short.
Right.
But have really long legs too, though, because that's set pretty far back.
I mean, the seat of the chair is as tall as the steering wheel.
Right. Your knees are actually higher than the steering wheel by the time you sit down.
Ridiculous.
Oh my God. At least it's got a beer holder for
while I'm
driving.
Oh my God. So it said something like the police officer pulled him over for something or other with moving violation, and when he walked up, noticed there weren't any seats in the vehicle except for a freaking camping chair.
I sold them. 20 bucks a piece.
Holy hell.
Yeah, he probably pulled him over because, like you said, he was driving with his head sticking out the sunroof.
In the snow. I was trying to catch snowflakes.
License and registration, please. Do you have any idea why I pulled you over? No? I don't know. I don't. Mm-mm. You got me.
So your head has been out of the sunroof for the last 20 miles? Holy hell.
People are amazing.
I know.
They're amazing.
I can't imagine. I mean, I've seen like, you know, rebuilds of hot rods and stuff. Like there was this one like delivery van, like a 1950s mm-hmm. delivery van or whatever. They had like a milk carton as the, like an upside down one, like a wooden one or whatever, as the base yep. for like a regular car seat. Just as like a rebuild right. for their vehicle. But like a camping chair, that was your best idea to put inside of a vehicle for driving around?
I was all out of other chairs. This is my chair. I've kind of broken it in just the way I like.
I don't know. One of those low rider beach chairs might have been better.
Right. Yes, that definitely would have been better. At least it's similar in height to a regular car seat. Which is a good question. Where did the other car seats go?
Yeah. Well, I mean, I like the battery that's sitting in the passenger seat location. Like,
yeah. And there's just the random wires in between the water.
Right.
It's like, water and snow, that's...
Okay.
Okay.
I mean, is there any place... Yeah, does that seatbelt look functional? It's there.
Do you think he wore it? I don't think he's... Where's it going to clip into?
That's what I was wondering. I mean, is that seatbelt attached to the seat, or does it go down to the floor, and there's like a just a loosey kind of clip that I don't see?
Yeah, that's probably half the seat. That's the belt part. There's no the buckle part.
Right.
I took the buckle part out.
With the seat.
It's got all belt.
Right? Got all belt. I would have used it, but I'm all belt, dude. I'm sorry.
Right, I'm all belt. But I got it.
I tied it around me.
Tied it in a knot.
You should see my Boy Scout skills of knotting.
Strongest one.
That's right.
I'm not going anywhere.
This is your this is your classic square knot. You know, if it I get into an accident, it's just gonna get tighter.
Right. It's actually just gonna cut me in half right at the waist. So damn tight. It'll actually pull us tighter.
Never loosens. Never loosens.
I just kicked the chair back a little bit.
Preempt my accident. You should see the whiplash protection on this chair. It's pretty amazing.
It's great.
Holy shit. All right. Questions from listeners. Our first one comes from @ We Live in Black Mirror. An argument over a Netflix password led to a stabbing in St. Louis overnight.
Give me that goddamn password.
Yeah. All right. Police were called to a home in the 600 block of North Kings Highway just past 5 a.m. Who the fuck's watching Netflix and being pissed at 5 a.m. in the morning?
I've been trying to watch all night.
It's Saturday. A 50-year-old man told detectives he got into an argument with his nephew after he tried to steal his Netflix password while he was sleeping. Oh, my God.
Where was the password that he would steal it? Like on a piece of paper?
I guess. Maybe on his phone?
How hard is it to be quiet, right?
The stupid floor!
You're not coming from my Netflix password, are you? Uncle John, get out of here. goddamn Netflix.
During the dispute, the nephew grabbed a kitchen knife and sliced the 50-year-old's old nose. 50-year-old's nose. Sorry. He ran off before police officers got there. Paramedics took the man to the hospital for treatment. No additional information has been released. All right, so the question is, anything stand out to you lately that seems like we're living in 1984, Brave New World, or an episode of Black Mirror?
I don't know. It seems to be a lot of overlords, people watching, and supervision, and restricting of things. There seems to be all sorts of...
There's a lot of 1980 stuff. So I said to my brother the other day, I don't know why this came up, but I was thinking about this. But I said, I'm like, did we grow up in like the best time ever? That everybody's making shows and movies and everything about it right now. Stranger Things. And
yeah, I guess so. I mean, definitely the 80s. I mean, I think enough time has passed now where it's, you know, it's now nostalgic enough. But like kids that's what's weird. I hate saying it and now it sound old saying it. But kids that are now like 2021, I mean, even mid-20s, they were born in the late 90s or turn of the century. So the 80s to them is the old days.
Right.
Where like when we were there, it was like, that's the same way that we probably think about like the 60s, like, oh, that was like a million years ago.
But still, you go to the bars and they play, right. They have 80s night.
Yeah, that's 80s night doesn't go anywhere. I was picking up dinner tonight, and I was just flipping through the radio, and the light station came on. They're like, "Oh, light music from the 80s through today." I was like, "Well, what happened in the 70s and 60s?
They didn't have light music back then.
Sure,
everything was too heavy.
Yeah, the heavy 70s.
That's right. You remember Marty McFly said everything was heavy?
Oh, yeah, so heavy. That was in the 50s.
That's right. Is there something different with the gravitational pull in the future?
Good question.
But yeah, I'd say I don't know. There's a lot of 80s stuff going on right now.
Yeah, definitely 80s is definitely a theme, but like 1984 and means more like Big Brother watching you, like government overwatching everything type thing. Black Mirror's, like, things just seem backwards, like, are we in bizarro world?
Right. I think so.
Yeah, oh, for sure. We're definitely in bizarro world.
I mean, we got people with broken backs who can't even be on podcasts, or we're definitely in bizarro world.
Right. Yep, they can make phone calls during the middle of it. It's so strange.
Right.
It's a strange episode of Black Mirror.
And you know that first comment out of his mouth from that phone call is going to have to make it into the podcast.
It should. It should make the cut. What do you send me nudie pictures for?
Yeah, I'm going to have to go on a porn sub. Pornhub.
I already have these ones.
Why are you sending me repeat pictures of stuff duplicates I already have? Oh my god. All right, well, thank you for the question at We Live in Black Mirror. And our last question comes from at Stupid Is Stupid Does. Stupid Is Stupid Does. A Michigan man with suspended license appears in virtual court hearing sitting in driver's seat of car. Oh my god. All right. The man was being sentenced after pleading to no insurance and driving with a suspended license on March 8th, but he was sitting in the driver's seat of his car during the hearing. Quote, "I believe you drove wherever you are in the vehicle you're in, and you're dumb enough to go on video with you sitting in the driver's seat of a vehicle. Makes me think you haven't gotten the message," end quote, says Judge Jeffrey Middleton. Oh my god. So the question is how does someone think they'll get away with this? I don't know.
Stupid. There's a lot of just stupid people is the only answer. Right. That's the only thing that makes sense.
I mean, are they at that age where maybe they're just too old to think, okay, I'm gonna join this meeting, but like my camera's not gonna be on, or people are just gonna see me, they won't see what's behind me.
This one was the opposite. I saw the picture of the guy, he was, I don't know, mid-20s. Whatever he was, not an old man.
So just dumb somebody enough to think that people are dumb enough to not notice what he's sitting in or where he is?
I think it's even stupider than that to not even put two and two together. To be like, oh, the background of where I am right now is the car.
Is the reason I'm like in the air.
The whole reason I have to get on this virtual court hearing. I think it's that stupid.
God.
He's like, oh, I got someplace to be. I got to get to work, or I got to pick up this new thing. But I got this freaking court case.
Got this stupid court case I forgot about. Ugh, yeah. I guess I'll just call from the car.
Yeah, I'll just call. And then I'll, you know, while I'm on the way.
It's like showing up for this type of thing, driving yourself to court and not having anybody else there. And the judge being like, how'd you get here? Well, I drove. What? So,
how'd you get there? Well, you're guilty.
You're driving with a suspended license.
It'll be $800.
Oh, my God. So how does anyone think?
I think there's a lot of stupid people.
Yeah,
I don't think they think.
Yeah, I think thinking has gone out the window. Everybody's just in Corona stupidity.
Yeah, we gave them too much credit that they would actually think.
Mm-hmm. Oh, that's my god!
The only thing that makes sense.
No, it's in the driveway. I didn't go anywhere. It was the only quiet place I could find.
Your Honor, listen. So it's not even my car that I'm sitting in, by the way.
My friend is right outside. Strange. He just let me sit in here because it was quieter.
Right. It's warm in here.
Jesus. Oh my god. That's just
Shut case. Open and shut case.
Ding ding. Nice. Holy hell. All right, well, thank you for the question. Stupid is stupid does. And yeah, that's pretty dumb.
Yeah, that's
pretty dumb. Work out.
He must.
All right, Flans, yay or nay or your beer? Oh, wait, tell me what the beer is you have first.
Oh, Cloud Source from Two Roads. It was a hazy, juicy IPA, and it was quite good. Okay. I would buy it again.
You would buy it again.
How about your?
My Intervase. It is tasty. I don't like grapefruit, and it has a definite grapefruit flavor to it, but it's not overwhelming to the point where I'm like not enjoying it.
Is it too big of a can?
Yeah.
Yeah,
it is taking a little while.
32 ounces is a lot.
Right. Especially at 8.2%, so I'm going to be toasty by the time I fall asleep. But it's I would try it again. I don't think I'd go out and buy it again, but because the flavor on the beer is good, I'm interested to see what else they have.
Okay, yeah.
So what do I say? Yeah, I say nay then, because I wouldn't buy it again, but I'm interested to see what else they have.
That's the criteria. So you'd go back to the brewery and try some of their other brews, but not this one.
Yeah, because the flavor on this is really good. It doesn't have a boozy flavor to it, even though it's 8.2. But I don't like grapefruit, and it's kind of grapefruity, so I don't know. But
yeah, and like you said, it's fairly local, so it's worth the trip. Try another one.
Yeah, exactly, 100%.
Yeah, that's like, well, I'll go back to Twin Elephant. They're not that far from me. So it was Magnify. It's very cool. I still have to get to Magnify.
Damn,
they're really
close. Look at you, microbrews all over the place.
Yeah, there is a bunch, actually. It's kind of nice.
All right, well, that's the show. I want to thank everybody for listening. If you guys have any questions, comments, feedback you want to prep to us, you can send it at The Loaded Couch on Twitter or theloadedcouch@gmail.com or www.theloadedcouch. You can reach us through there, I think. But yeah, hit us up. Questions, comments, feedback. We'd appreciate it. Whatever's, I will be sure to check this one in on Untappd as soon as I'm done with recording. So hopefully you'll see it and you won't have to yell at me again. I don't like it when you yell at me.
Reduce any points.
That's right. Yeah, exactly. but thank you guys so much for listening. And we'll catch you next week.
Later.
We'll be right back.